Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about ANN based MPPT applied to solar PV powered water pumping system using BLDC motor. So thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. So first we are going to see about this topology of ANN based MPPT for solar PV powered water pumping application using BLDC motor. So here you can see that block diagram for the proposed system. So it consists of PV array and then DC to DC boost converter, and then three phase voltage source inverter, and then BLDC motor with the water pumping arrangement, and also it have neural network MPPT. So it receive two inputs, one is solar radiation and cell temperature, and then output will be the reference voltage, that mean voltage at maximum power point for the different irradiation temperature condition. So here we have to compare this reference voltage with the actual PV panel voltage. After that, we have to process via PA controller. So PA controller generate the duty cycle. The duty cycle going to be processed via PWM generator. The PWM generator generate the pulse for this IGBT or MOSFET in order to extract the maximum power from the PV panel. So next stage, you have to use the that means here we are going to control the BLDC motor. So based upon Hall sensor and then DC link voltage. Okay. So here we are going to generate that means measure the Hall sensor. After that sensing the Hall sensor output, right? It's going to be converted into switching pulses for S1 to S6 of the voltage sourcing motor. Okay, here. Next we have to measure the DC link voltage here, and then it's going to be compared with some reference DC voltage, and it's going to be processed by a PA controller, and then processed by a PWM generator, and then it will generate the pulse. So this pulse and the pulse from this switching sequence generator going to be added together, and then final pulse going to be given to the switches in the voltage source motor in order to control the BLDC motor. Okay, so this is operation of this ANN MPPT applied to the solar PV powered water pumping application using BLDC motor. So this is going to be implemented in the MATLAB Simulink environment. So let's start with the MATLAB implementation of this. Okay, so here in order to design this process, okay, so first you have to fix the rating of this BLDC motor. Okay, so here I'm going to use rating of the BLDC motor from some standard manufacturing data. So here you can see that, so this rating of BLDC motor, so the voltage, rated voltage is 48 volt, and the rated power is 500 watts, rated torque is 1.27, and then rated speed is 3000 rpm, and rated current is 7.4 amps, and then here you can see that voltage constant, torque constant at the moment of inertia, and then resistance and inductance of the BLDC motor. Okay, so this data going to be used for designing the BLDC motor. So this can be designed by using this one option is available in the this block, right? Complete from standard manufacturer specification, right? Just you have to click this one and then feed the detail, right? So just you have to choose trapezoidal and then type that resistance value 0.94 and then inductance equal to 1.19, and then select the torque constant. And then torque constant is in terms of Newton meter per amps, right? So this value is 0.128. And then next you got to type moment of inertia, So kg centimeter square. So this value is 0.51. So and then click this compute block parameters, right? After clicking that one, you will get the parameter for this Belt-DC motor, right? So you can use this value in order to design that 500 watts Belt-DC motor. Okay, the same thing will be applied here, right? So this machine now is rated at 500 watts and to 48 volt, right? So next, so the rating of Belt-DC motor is 500 watts. So we need to select that solar PV panel also, right? So before that, we need to make this Belt-DC motor as a water pump, right? So for that, we need to create, so you have to find out some K value, right? That mean, yeah, this K value. So this K value calculated based upon this formula. So K equal to power divided by omega cube. So omega nothing but the angular speed, right? So here the power is 500 watts, right? 500 watts. And then rated speed is 3000 rpm, right? So based upon the value, you have to calculate K, and then you have to find out the relation between torque and speed, right? Okay, so normally the relation with torque and speed will be the torque equal to, that means load torque, which is equal to K into omega square. So this is the relation of that load torque and speed of the Belt-DC motor when we have to apply Belt-DC motor in the water pumping application. Okay, so next to process, you have to calculate K value. So calculation of K value here is that value of K is 1.6126 e power minus 5. Okay, so now this Belt-DC motor can be act as a water pump. Okay, and then here you can see that we are measuring the Hall sensor output. So the Hall sensor output is converted into back EMF, and then back EMF going to be converted into gating pulse, right, for that voltage source inverter. So this is act as a voltage source inverter. Okay, so next you have to, here you can, so this is a DC-DC boost converter, right? So here we have to measure the converter output voltage and compare with some reference voltage. So here we are going to fix reference voltage is 60. Okay, so you have to maintain a voltage across this voltage source inverter, that means input of voltage source inverter around 60 volt, right? So and then it's going to be processed via PID controller and then processed via PWM generator. So it will generate the pulse, PWM pulse. So that going to be ended with the switching sequence from this gating generator, gate generator, right? So and finally it going to be given to that voltage source inverter to control the Belt-DC motor. Okay, so next you have to, that mean the power of the Belt-DC motor is 500 watts already I told, right? So we need to select the PV panel rating. So here we are using the PV panel, right? Single panel rating is around 250 watts, right? So I'm going to take a series, that mean single series model. And then that mean we are going to use two PV panel. The PV panel can be connected in parallel, right? So here you can see that series string is one and then parallel string is two, right? That mean when connected in parallel, it increases the current rating, but we have to maintain the voltage across the panels around 30.7 at the standard testing condition. Okay, so these are the rating of this PV panel, right? So based upon this rating, right, PV panel rating and Belt-DC motor rating, so you have to design this DC-DC converter, right? So here we design, that mean that voltage across this panel will be around 30.7, and then voltage across this panel is 60 volt, right? And then you have to fix the output current and the ripple factor of the ripple factor for the inductor, that means ripple inductor current factor, and then ripple voltage percentage, right? Everything you have to fix, and then you have to design the value of L and C. Okay, and next you have to see about MPPT algorithm. So here you can see that we have to use MPPT algorithm. So if you want to know more about that MPPT algorithm, you can see my early video, so you can go my YouTube channel and then you can check the neural network MVPT concept. So already we posted that working of the neural network MVPT, so you can get more detail on that, right? So here you can see that this is neural network MVPT. It received two inputs, one is irradiation and then temperature. So output will be reference voltage, that mean voltage at maximum power point reference. So that one be compared with the PV panel voltage, actual PV panel voltage, and process via PID controller and then PWM generator. So it will generate the pulse for this IGBT in order to extract the maximum power from the PV panel. Okay. So this is a MVPT algorithm applied in the solar PV system, right? That means ANN based MVPT. So now I'm going to fix initially radiation equal to 1000, and then you have to check the results of the system. Okay. So here you can see that there are different scopes there, right? So this scope used for measuring the PV power, converter power, PV voltage and converter voltage. And then this is used for measuring the stator current and EMF of the BLDC motor. So this is used for measuring the rotor speed. And then, so this is used for measuring the electromagnetic torque. And then, so this is used for measuring line to line voltage of the BLDC motor. Okay. So now I'm going to simulate this model. So here you can see that here we are fixing irradiation to 1000 and temperature 25 degrees Celsius. So PV power is around 500 watts and converter power is around nearer to 500. That means it's less than the PV power. And then here you can see the PV voltage around 30.7, and then here the converter voltage is maintained at 60 watt because we set the reference voltage 60 in that DC in voltage control, right? So here you can see that this is a rotor speed of the BLDC motor is around 2700. So this is electromagnetic torque of the BLDC motor, and then this is known as stator current and EMF, and then line to line voltage. So now I'm going to change the irradiation to 500, and then you have to check the response of the system and also check the response of this converter voltage, right? So now I'm going to change this irradiation to 500, right? And then you have to check the response. So now we can see that after changing irradiation from 1000 to 500, now we can see the PV power comes to 250 watts, and then converter power also comes to nearly 240 watts, and then the voltage, the PV voltage is maintained at 30.7 volt, nearly to 30.7 volt. And also you can see that because of DC link voltage controller, right, the converter voltage maintained at 60 volt, right, even though change in irradiation condition. And then you can see the power, that means rotor speed and torque of the machine. So it reduced because of PV power, right? PV power now is 250 watts. That's why the speed of the machine comes to 2200 RPM and torque comes to around 0.8 Newton meter, right? So now I'm going to increase this irradiation to 1000, and then you have to check the response of the system. Now you can see that now that so that in PV power comes to nearly 500 watts and converter power comes to near 490 or 495 watts. And then you can see that so voltage is that in PV voltage maintained at 30 volt or 30.7 volt, and then converter voltage is maintained at 60 volt, right, because of the DC link voltage controller. Here now we can see that power, that means speed of the machine comes to 2700 RPM and torque comes to 1.27 Newton meter, right? So for different change in irradiation condition, for varying irradiation condition, the maximum power from the PV panel is extracted by means of ANN MVPT. And also that because of this DC link voltage control, the converter voltage is maintained at 60 volt always for for the change in radiation condition, right? So this is working of AN and BPT applied to the solar PV powered water pumping application using PLDC motor. So thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Okay, thank you so much.